risen, and death is no more. Christ is risen, and darkness is no more. Christ is risen, and illness is no more. Christ is risen, and death has no more dominion over us. Why are we so worthy of God's love? Why are we so worthy of God's mercy? Why are we so worthy of God's forgiveness? He came to restore the fallen human nature. This human nature was meant to be in the presence of God, in the garden, to be with Him, to walk with Him, to see God. He took the nails in His hands and His feet. He took the scourging, the spitting and the mocking for me and you. Are we worthy of that? There's no love greater than God's love for all of us. No greater love. Because He laid His life on the cross for me and you. What are we doing with our lives? What are we doing with this love? So many people reject this love. They're not capable of accepting God's love that's given to us freely, abundantly. He came meek so that we can be glorified. He came and took the pain on the cross so that we can have everlasting rest in His kingdom. That's the God that we believe in, and no other God. Let's sanctify this time. Let's come back to this path, God's path. Look how close you are now to your faith. If we are wise, I've said this from the beginning, we take this time to sanctify our lives. Don't think less of yourselves. We are created for sainthood. We are all saints in progress. Take your call seriously. All of us are called to do that, beginning with me. Let us take our call to holiness seriously. You are capable of holiness. You are capable of sainthood. Be mindful at all times. When this is all said and done, don't forget this holy time. This is a holy time. Don't forget it.
Go! you make.